السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح حي على الفلاح الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله
لا إله إلا الله الحمد لله رب العالمين إن الحمد لله نحمده ونشكره ونستعين به ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله تعالى من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما All praises due to Allah. We praise him, we thank him, we seek his help and forgiveness, and we seek refuge in Allah from the evil of our own souls and that of our bad deeds. Whomsoever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guides will never go astray, and whomsoever is led astray, no one can guide. I bear witness, I testify openly that there is no God worthy of worship except Allah. And Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the messenger of Allah. We praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for everything he has given us today. We praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the one who gave us the ability to wake up today and have opportunities to come to the masjid to witness Salat al-Jumu'ah and to attend this great time where other people are not able to come. So we are in a great ni'mah from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to attend and to perform Salat al-Jumu'ah in time. فَالْحَمْدُ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ Of course, other people has an excuse, but still we gain a lot of blessings and rewards from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to fight against these conditions of this bad weather and this freezing and this snow, to come to the masjid just for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and to be amongst those people who are called upon in Surah Al-Jumu'ah, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا إِذَا نُودِيَ لِلصَّلَاةِ مِنْ يَوْمِ الْجُمُعَةِ فَاسْعَوْا إِلَىٰ ذِكْرِ اللَّهِ. When it is the call for prayer on the day of Jumu'ah, then rush to the remembrance of Allah and leave all of the worldly affairs behind. Just come to the masjid to worship Allah and to pray Salat al-Jumu'ah. فَالْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ. القرآن الكريم يشتمل على أوامر ونواهي وقصص وتشريعات إلى آخر ما في القرآن العظيم. فإذا أمر الله سبحانه وتعالى بأمر فلينتبه له المسلم وليبذل كل الجهد في تحقيق هذا الأمر وفي الامتثال لأمر الله تعالى، حيث قال سبحانه: يا أيها الذين آمنوا استجيبوا لله وللرسول إذا دعاكم لما يحييكم. الله سبحانه وتعالى says: all believers, all people who believed in him سبحانه وتعالى, respond positively to the call of Allah سبحانه وتعالى. Let's take a look on one of the commandments of Quran to see and try to examine our iman and try to check up our hearts to see if we still need to purify our hearts, and we do, because the act of the heart, purifying the heart, is a thing that we should work hard on it every single day. يقول الله تعالى: وسارعوا إلى مغفرة من ربكم وجنة عرضها السماوات والأرض. Race, hasten to attain the forgiveness of your Lord and to attain the paradise, which is as wide as the heavens and the earth collectively. Now this verse starts with a direct commandment, hasten. And another verse in the same context, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Surah Al-Hadid, سابقوا, race. So it's like a race. Each and every one of us tries to get to the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala first. All of us try to prove our iman and to draw closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So, وَسَارِعُوا إِلَىٰ مَغْفِرَةٍ مِّن رَبِّكُمْ وَجَنَّةٍ عَرْضُهَا السَّمَاوَاتُ وَالْأَرْضُ. Once we hear about this great rewards, which is Jannah, which is as wide as the heavens and the earth, which has everything even beyond our imagination, all of blessings and all of happiness and all of na'im is embedded in the paradise, is offered for those people who will be admitted to paradise. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us all amongst those people who will be in paradise, inshallah. Allahumma ameen. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, أُعِدَّتْ لِلْمُتَّقِينَ. This na'im, this jannah, this paradise is prepared for the pious people, the righteous people, the people who follow the way of Rasulullah Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Still, we need to know some of the characteristics and some of the attributes of those people in order for us to be amongst them, in order for us to examine our hearts and to try to rectify our behavior and to get closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala through attaining these characteristics, or at least some of these characteristics. What is the very first and the foremost characteristics that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has mentioned when he talks about the righteous people? Those people who will be in paradise, those people who will be having this na'im and will be with the companionship of Rasulullah Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. You and I are expected to be the perform prayer, make siyam, go to make hajj. Those are the pillars of Islam. Of course, they come first. But look how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants to purify our hearts and wants us to be always have a connection with him subhanahu wa ta'ala on a daily basis. He says, Subhanahu wa ta'ala, now we are going to count some of the characteristics of the righteous people who will be deserved to be in Jannah by the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The very first condition is, الَّذِينَ يُنْفِقُونَ فِي السَّرَّاءِ وَالضَّرَّاءِ. Those who spend some of their money in prosperity and in adversity, in ease and in hardship. No matter what my condition is, still I need to pay for the sake of Allah, to give in the cause of Allah, to draw closer to Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. There is no specific amount in terms of charity, but still we need to fight against our desires and to draw closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by giving in charity and donation to the best of our abilities. Because when we do this, we actually build our house in paradise, which is our real life, our final destination, as we say. الَّذِينَ يُنْفِقُونَ فِي السَّرَّاءِ وَالضَّرَّاءِ. Those who spend in all conditions, whether they are having much money or even short in money, they try to spend a very small amount of money just to purify themselves. خُذْ مِنْ أَمْوَالِهِمْ صَدَقَةً تُطَهِّرُهُمْ وَتُزَكِّيهِمْ بِهَا. The charity you give for the sake of Allah actually purify ourselves and will cause our sins to be forgiven by the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So, الَّذِينَ يُنْفِقُونَ فِي السَّرَّاءِ وَالضَّرَّاءِ. Those who spend in all conditions. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guided you to be amongst those people who are keen to spend for the sake of Allah, then you are in a great ni'mah. If you try to support your masjid, the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, be sure that each and every one stepped into the masjid to pray, you have a share in this ajr. Each and every one stepped into the masjid to get the knowledge, you have a share in this ajr. It's like an ongoing charity. Sadaqatun jariyah. Everything you try to help the masjid with, you are exposing yourself to the mercy of Allah, to the everlasting rewards. Because this masjid, inshallah, we hope that it will be open forever, inshallah. But it needs your help. It needs the help of each and every one to keep the masjid open and to help teach the next generation, because they will be the leaders of the future. Your kids, your sons, your daughters. This is our shelter. This is our real house. If we build here, if we support here, then we are giving the right way and the guidance to the hearts of our children and to the hearts of the next generation. Those people and this generation, may Allah protect them all and give them the guidance and the light into their hearts. They will be facing a lot of troubles and a lot of tribulations into this life and into this place and everywhere actually around the world. But when they have a connection to the masjid, when their hearts is attached to the masjid, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will facilitate their affairs and will make it easy for them to confront all of the waves of shaitan and of the bad people, and to be always on the track, on the straight path. That's why we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in each and every rak'ah in our prayer, اهدنا الصراط المستقيم. Guide us all, ourselves, our children, our relatives, all the Muslim ummah. اهدنا الصراط المستقيم. That's why you see here that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants you to give. Why? To prove your iman and to prove that your heart is attached to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And if we want to talk about the rewards you get from giving in the cause of Allah, we need the whole day to talk about it. It's enough to know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala specified one type of people among seven of them. Those people who will have a shelter under the throne of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on the day of judgment, those people who try to spend in the cause of Allah, so much so that their left hand is not aware of what their right hand has been giving. ورجل تصدق بصدقة فأخفاها حتى لا تعلم شماله ما أنفقت يمينه. ومطلع الحديث: سبعة يظلهم الله في ظله يوم لا ظل إلا ظله. اللهم اجعلنا وأولادنا منهم يا أرحم الراحمين. So we are here gathering, want to make the most of our life and the most of these few minutes and to get the benefit and try to again to fight against our desires, because this dunya is full of tribulations. This dunya looks bright and shiny, but still it's temporary. Our real life is in paradise. And Allah gives us this great gift and this great opportunity. من بنى بيتا لله بنى الله له به بيتا في الجنة. Whoever builds a house for Allah, like a masjid, Allah will build a house in return for you in paradise. You are not supposed to build the whole mosque and the whole masjid, but at least to participate. And still, you keep the same rewards because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the most generous. الَّذِينَ يُنفِقُونَ فِي السَّرَّاءِ وَالضَّرَّاءِ. What is the next characteristic of those people? وَالْكَاظِمِينَ الْغَيْظِ وَالْعَافِينَ عَنِ النَّاسِ. Both are related. Those who control their anger and then they pardon other people. This is something that we need to train ourselves on it. It's not easy to control your rage, your anger, and on top of that, to pardon other people for the sake of Allah. Because some of us might control their anger, but it's still deep in our hearts, we still hold some of the, you know, of the things towards other people that we might pass by them and don't shake hands and don't say assalamu alaikum. This is not the real pardoning and the real forgiveness. The real one is to forgive and forget. Why? Because you are aiming to have the rewards from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَالْكَاظِمِينَ الْغَيْظَ وَالْعَافِينَ عَنِ النَّاسِ. And all of you know the story of this companion who had this glad tidings from the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam that he is from the people of Jannah. He is walking amongst you, but he is from the people of Jannah. يَدْخُلُ عَلَيْكُمْ رَجُلٌ الْآنْ مِنْ أَهْلِ الْجَنَّةِ. قالها النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم ثلاث مرات ثلاثة أيام. Three days in a row the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم made it clear that a specific man who will be stepping into the masjid, he is absolutely from the people of Jannah. Sahaba starting to murmur and to know what's going on. Why is it that this man got this great rewards and this great glad tidings? And they start to follow him to see what is special does this man do? And they found nothing. And they started to ask him, the Prophet is saying so and so, why? What is special do you do? He says, nothing, I pray as you do. And I make siyam as you do. Everything, you may be better than me in terms of ibadah, but there is one simple thing. What is that? Whenever I go to bed, every night, before I go to sleep, I pardon everyone for the sake of Allah. يعفو عن جميع الناس بينه وبين نفسه وبينه وبين ربه فماذا كان جزاؤه هو من أهل الجنة. انظر كيف إن هذه الأمور لا تكلفنا شيئا. والله إن الذي يعني يحافظ أو يحفظ الغضب في صدره وفي قلبه ويمسك عليه إنما يضر نفسه. الإنسان الذي يعفو يريح نفسه أولا ويفوز بالأجر والثواب براحة البال في الدنيا وبالنعيم في الآخرة. So if you are amongst those people who pardon for the sake of Allah, those people who forgive and forget, you are bringing relief to your own self first and you are preparing yourself to the na'im of Jannah in the hereafter inshallah. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us amongst those people who spend in his cause in all conditions and also to make us amongst those people who forgive and forget and pardon for his sake. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله العظيم لي ولكم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله ولي الصالحين، وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمد رسول الله الصادق الوعد الأمين. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد وآله وصحبه، واجمعنا اللهم به في مستقر رحمتك ودار كرامتك يا رب العالمين. وبعد، فإني أوصيكم ونفسي بتقوى الله تعالى، فهي النجاة في الدنيا والآخرة، وينجي الله الذين اتقوا بمفازتهم، لا يمسهم السوء ولا هم يحزنون. والله إن القلب ليطرب فرحا من هذه الوجوه الناضرة وهذه الوجوه المنيرة التي أتت إلى المسجد في هذا الظرف وفي هذا البرد القاسي. نسأل الله تعالى أن يرفع لكم الدرجات، وأن يحط عنا وعنكم السيئات، وأن يجزينا بالإحسان إحسانا، وبالسوء مغفرة وغفرانا. اللهم آمين. من مظاهر التيسير في شرعنا الحنيف أنه شرع لنا أن نجمع الصلاة في حال المرض أو السفر أو البرد الشديد أو في حال ما كان هناك أي أمر طارئ. لذلك دائما نقول إن الدين يسر، الدين يسر، وقال الله تعالى وما جعل عليكم في الدين من حرج. اليوم بإذن الله تعالى نجمع الظهر مع العصر بعد أن ننتهي من صلاة الجمعة في وقتها، الآن إن شاء الله نصلي معا صلاة العصر. فما هي أحكام الجمع باختصار؟ الجمع له أذان واحد وإقامتان، وهذا هو فعل النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم في حجة الوداع، حيث جمع الظهر مع العصر جمع تقديم بأذان واحد وإقامتين في عرفة، وجمع المغرب والعشاء جمع تأخير بأذان واحد وإقامتين في المزدلفة. ولنا في سيدنا رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم الأسوة، لقد كان لكم في رسول الله أسوة حسنة. We are going إن شاء الله to combine both ظهر and عصر، I mean جمعة and عصر إن شاء الله consecutively. They should be, you know, together right after each other without no pausing or waiting between two prayers. We need just to make one أذان and we've done it الحمد لله before صلاة الجمعة، and two إقامة، one separate إقامة for each prayer. And this was the action of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam in his last Hajj, in his farewell pilgrimage. He prayed sallallahu alayhi wasallam dhuhr and asr combined with one adhan and two iqamas in Arafah, and he prayed maghrib and isha with one adhan and two iqamas in al-Muzdalifah. Nas'alullah ta'ala an yu'allimana wa iyyakum ma yanfa'una، وأن ينفعنا بما يعلمنا، وأن يزيدنا علما، وأن يتقبل منا ومنكم الصالحات، وأن يغفر عنا السهو والزلات. اللهم تب علينا لنتوب، واغفر لنا الذنوب، تولى يا رب أمرنا، وأحسن خلاصنا، وخذ بأيدينا يا أرحم الراحمين. سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون، وسلام على المرسلين، والحمد لله رب العالمين، وأقم الصلاة.